Inside Rattlers Football. I'm Peter Garbo. To my right here is Matt Aglesky. The Rattlers faced the Cedar Rapids twice, back-to-back, and they won both games. The first one was a pretty close one, 84-83. This Saturday, 57-42. The game was pretty neck and neck through the first half, but a big third quarter, big defense, ended up winning the game.
Yeah, and it's now a 7-game win streak now for the Rattlers. Their first place lead grew a little bit after Iowa beat Sioux Falls over the weekend. So if you're a Rattlers fan, got to be excited.
That's right. Let's get to the highlights.
Rattlers got on the board first off of a 16-yard pass from Jeff Ziemba to Desmond Epps. Early in the second, Rattlers up 6. Jake Medlock rushes up the middle to tie the game at 20 apiece.
Yeah, the game was a real back-and-forth battle up until this point.
Late in the first half, Rattlers up 7 when Daryl Monroe rushes 4 yards for the score.
Monroe had another big game this week, rushing for 111 yards and 3 touchdowns.
Start of the third quarter, Cedar Rapids trying to get back in this game when a bad handoff from Jake Medlock to Lawson Gale was recovered in the end zone by defensive end Chris McAllister.
And the Rattlers took a 20-point lead with this score. At this point, the game started to slip away from the Titans.
47-20 now. Medlock goes to pass, but the ball was intercepted by Keith Trumps.
Yeah, Trump seemed to be all over the field on Saturday. He had 6.5 tackles and an interception.
The Titans would go on a late run, but in the end, the Rattlers would take home the 57-42 victory.
The Rattlers defense were pleased to welcome back Justin Shirk against Cedar Rapids. Since his return, Shirk has recorded 12 total tackles, 2 tackles for loss, and 1 sack. We had a chance to speak with him today.
I think we just had a different mentality defensive-wise. You know, after playing them last week, an 84-83 shootout, we had to refocus, have a different mentality, play more physical, get after the quarterback more, and I think we did that this game. You know, it was my second game back after my injury, after my knee, so just having that extra confidence in myself and in my body to go out there and play, you know, worry-free, not to worry about my knee at all, and just focus on the game and the game plan that we had was good. And like I said, I felt good. Everybody else has been playing all season. I have had a little rest, so I just definitely played into it. So just feeling good right now.
I think it's been up and down. You know, I think as you know, most of the guys here on the defensive side have been here since last year. So we all know each other. We know how each other plays. There's only a couple new additions to the team this year, like Day-Day and you know Trumps. But you know, for the most part, and JT in the front as well. But for the most part, I think we're playing, you know, good solid football. Just going to get back to the basics, do our stuff, tackle, cover, get pressure on the quarterback. You know, all that stuff will kind of, you know, once it comes together, you know, turnovers will happen, we'll get sacks, we'll start dominating the game more instead of, you know, letting the teams back in.
The way this season is shaping up for the Rattlers have a commanding lead in first place. The only team that's kind of close to them are the Iowa Barnstormers, who we face in 2 weeks. But in the meantime, we're facing the Green Bay Blizzard, who are coming off their first win in a commanding fashion against the Nebraska Danger.
Yeah, and their quarterback had a big game last week. Brian Hicks, 6 touchdowns against Nebraska. It's a new coaching staff. They're starting to figure things out. They've played the Rattlers twice already, so can't take anything for granted.
That's right. You can catch the game live on YouTube this Saturday at 5 o'clock Pacific.